Okay, so we're just going to do some nice arm stuff.
Good.
We're going to reverse those circles in 3, 2, 1, and reverse. Now, just think about your posture. Make sure you're standing up nice and tall, abs are nice and tight, shoulders relaxed. And you should be on your weight is distributed through your feet, your knees are soft. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's take those arms forward and back. Good. Keep those abs nice and tight. Forward and back. Good. 4, 3, 2, 1. Take the arms out and rotate. Good. Just nice and easy, nice and gentle. Squeezing those tummy muscles. Good. Try and relax the shoulders, keep the knees nice and soft. We're here for 2 and 1. And now we're going to go back into those back muscles. Good. Soft knees, abs are up. 4, 3, 2, 1. Now let's bring the torso and the hips in. Nice big deep hip rotation, taking it all the way back, all the way forward. Keeping the knees nice and soft. Weight is evenly distributed. We're going to reverse that in 3, 2, and 1. Take it back round the other way. Good. Keep this torso and core nice and strong and tight. We're here for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now we're going to open up the hips and then reverse that. Change legs. Good. Out and in. Take it out. Bring it in. Good job. Take it out. Bring it in. We've got one more of those on each leg. Good job. Now take it nice and wide, toes pointing forward, knees are soft, and we're just going to squat it down. I think we have someone else that's joined us today, so hello to you. This is just our warm-up section, guys. We started warming up our upper body, our core, hips, glutes. Now we're moving down the leg. Just with a few little squats. We're here for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now we're just going to raise the heart rate a little bit. So nice and bit of gentle jogging. Good. Nice and light on the toes. Core is strong. Crunch it out. Good. Now keep breathing here and punch it up. Good. Nice and easy. We're just warming up the body, lubricating the joints. Ready for some jump jacks in 3, 2, 1. Nice and steady. Now remember your alternative to the jump jacks. We can take it out one at a time. You choose whichever you want to do. Keep breathing. Ready for those boxy shuffles. In 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Light on the toes. Abs are tight. Squeeze the tummy. Come on, squeeze it. Good. 4, 3, 2, 1. Running on the spot. I'm going to sprint for 10 seconds. In 3, 2, 1, sprint. Faster, come on, you've got some more in there. 3, 2, 1. Jog it out, good. We do that one more time. In 3, 2, 1, and sprint. Come on, faster, faster. Those arms, push. Well done, guys. Let's grab a quick drink. I'll just stop. Okay. So nicely warm to keep the legs moving. Okay, so I'm just going to make sure you're all muted so I don't hear you. I think everybody's muted. Okay, so welcome to those that popped in a little bit late. Hopefully you're nice and warm. If you're not, well, I'm just explaining this, just keep those legs moving. Maybe do some little heel jigs, toe taps, just to make sure you're thoroughly warmed up. It's really important. So we're going to start off with the biggest muscle group today, as we do always, those good old legs. So join in, do what you can. I will always show you modifications if I feel it's necessary. If at any time you need to take the impact out of the exercise, so if we're doing a jump squat, for instance, and you don't want to do the impact, you just do the squat, or you might do a, yep. So you work at the level that's right for you. It's really important. If you've got any injuries at all, and if something starts hurting, then you modify the exercise, or again, just come back either to a little squat or a little toe tap. Just try and keep your legs moving. So without further ado, guys, we are going to start with some good old squats, because we do like a bit of a squat. So what's a squat look like? So what we do is we just make sure that we're trying to sit down on that invisible chair. Join in when you're ready. Come with me, guys, come on. I'm not doing all the work today, so you've got to join in soon. All right, so there's my little stool. I'm just going to tap my bottom on it. So I want to make sure that my knees stay in line with my toes. Just as high. And I keep breathing. That's important here. Good. Keep that going. Now, where are my feet? My feet are about hip distance apart, maybe a little wider. Toes are just slightly pointing out. Good. So we should now feel a little bit of warmth in those thighs and glutes. This is what we're aiming for. We're going to do 8 more here, and then I'm going to ramp it up a little bit. So we've got 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay. We're going for a little shuffle, 3 to the side. 1, 2, 3, and squat. 1, 2, 3. Now, you don't have to do a jump. You can just squat it down. 1, 2, 3, squat. 1, 2, 3, squat. Keep that chest high. You can. I'm looking for a shuffle and a jump. Good. Now, the plyometric part of this, the jump, is where we raise the heart rate, get that metabolic heart rate high, start burning extra calories. So if that's what you're looking to do, then do what you can and join me. Good. Keep it going. Remember, for any time you start getting a bit out of breath or more out of breath than you should be, just go back to the squats. That's fine. It's all about challenging yourself and doing what you can. A few more here. Good. Last 2. Good. Back to just that squat. Now make sure we've got that full range of movement. Good. Grab a drink if you need to. And breathe. Are you ready to do some pulses? Oh, we love a bit of pulsing. Are you ready? Here we go. Hold it down. Hold it down. And pulse. Come on, you can do this. Chest is high.
Chin up. Breathe through. This should work in recovery. Good. Suck in that tummy. Push up that bottom. Nearly there. Eight to go. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. One.
And stand up and shake it out. Another quick drink. Just keep those legs moving. We've just got a few seconds here. And then I'm going to go back into those big muscle glutes again, one more time. Alrighty. So we're going to do a little bit of a lunge now. So first of all, we're just going to start off just a nice little bit of lunging. Not too deep. Let's get those hip flexors nice and mobile before we really crack it up. So we're just lunging it back from the side. Again, you want that chest high, that knee down as far as you can take it. Just as far as it's comfortable for you to go. Good. We've got four more here. Now you can stay with this. Or, if you can, we're going to do some jump lunges. In three. And two. Remember, stay here if you don't want to do these jump lunges. It's not right for you, stay where you are. Just keep moving. Alrighty, here we go. This is where you need to challenge yourself, guys. You may just do a couple of these and then some lunges. Yeah, you choose what's right for you. Good. Breathe through. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, and back to lunge. Woo! I've got the old heart rate up. Keep going on your own. Back your door. Miss a bear. Good. Nice work. Fabulous, guys. Breathe through. Work in recovery. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Shake it out. Good. Keep those legs moving. Don't let them stop. Grab a drink. All right. So this one, if you can use some dumbbells, you don't need to. I'm going to use some little windmills to strengthen the back of the leg, right into this glute area. So to begin with, I'm just going to bend down and touch the toes. Now what I want you to do, if you can, is to lock out those knees. I know. Jan, what are you saying? We never lock out our knees. I know, guys, on this occasion, we're looking to strengthen those muscles that run out the back of the legs. So we need to work them a little bit harder. However, if you have a problem with an ankle, knee, maybe tight hip flexors. If you can't do it with a straight leg, then I want you to have a slight bend in your knee. Let me look at you. Good. Excellent work. Lovely. We've got eight more here. Keep that chest high, guys, when you come down. Three. Two.
You're going to stay doing this or you're going to follow me.
And we're going to do it high. So still that lovely leg work. We're just incorporating a little bit more of that core. And those lovely arms and shoulders. Who likes doing a full body exercise? I know you do. And this is a great one. This is a great one for you. Keep that breathing going. Regulate it. Are you sucking in that tummy?
Yes.
Good. That's the answer I need. We've got four more to go here. And then we're going to go straight into some curtsies. We all have a good curtsy. So hold those weights in front. What about you? I'm ready for my knighthood. So, right leg, behind left. Just going to do one side to begin with. Here we go. Yes, Your Majesty. I would love to have my knighthood. Thank you. We still got to squeeze those cores though, ladies. Don't let me down. Squeeze it in. Good. Now you can stay here on this leg if you want to, or you can now take your curtsy forward and back. Do you see the difference there? My left, right leg went in front of my left and then behind. Now if that isn't right for you, for whatever reason, you stay with the curtsy going behind. Lovely. We've got eight more here, that's all. Easy. Nearly done this leg. Six more to go. Six more front and back. Or if you're just doing it one side, you've got 12. Or 5 and 10. Four more to go. Here we go, ladies. We're at the end of this leg. But we are going to go straight into the other leg. We don't want to hang around. But if you need to grab a drink in between, have a few seconds out, please do. It's all important. This is your exercise. I'm just here to guide you through, challenge you a little bit, encourage you a lot. I've absolutely lost count. So we're going to do one more forward and back, or if you're just doing one side too. Last one. Alrighty, let's start on that other leg. Left leg's going to just go behind, just one way. Warm up the hip. Good. You're all looking really fabulous out there. Keep it going. Hope you're singing along to your own music. Because you're allowed to in your living room. We have to stop singing in the studio. It's very often too. Okay, let's do 8 here. And then you're going to stay with this. Or we're going to do our crisscross, front and back. I think we have 4 more to go here. Now you want to try and get that knee nice and low. Really work this outer hip. Don't have to use your weights, remember. You can just do it with your body weight. Last one. Now, if you're with me, forward and back. You're going to feel a slightly different tension in the hip, in the glute area. Because although it's the same exercise, because it's a variant, what we need to do is we shake those muscles up. We're throwing them a curveball, basically, because they don't know what we're doing now. Wait, hang on a minute. I thought what happened a second ago. What's going on? That's what it's all about, challenging ourselves, challenging our muscles. Good. We need to keep those muscles nice and strong, but equally and probably maybe even more importantly,
I need to get the joints supple. Because we get older, we get less lubricant in those joints. And this is why, if you don't exercise, you're going to find yourself stiffening up. Mm. You might struggle at the moment getting out of a chair. So ask yourself that question. Do I? Why is that? It's nothing to do with age. It's because you're not using your joints. That's what it is. Simple as. So, use them. Walk, cycle, a little bit of cardio, a little bit of weights and resistance, a couple of times a week to start off with, and then grow from there. But have those rest days. It's important, we need those muscles to grow. When we work them, we shred them. They need to grow back. So we need to have a good nutritional diet, proteins, fat, good fat, carbs, good carbs, and then they'll grow back. That's four. I know I've been jumping on a lot. It takes my mind off it. Nearly there. Two to go. How are we doing for time? Ooh, lovely. So we've got one more little upright exercise. Take it down, put the waist down. Shake up those legs. One more little exercise. Working on those upper, lower body limbs. And this one we're going to add a bit of cardio to it if you want. If not, you stay where you are. Just going to move your weights out of the way. If you're jumping, make sure you've got a clear area. It's very easy to step on something without realising it. So, next exercise is crisscross squat. We've all done this before. Crisscross squat. So we're taking the crisscross. So one leg in front, then behind, then into that squat. So give it a go. If it's not for you, what am I going to say? Suggest you do. Take it forward, take it back, squat it down. Take it forward, take it back, squat it down. Now join me in the level you're looking to do. Take it forward, push it back, squat it down. Good. This is our last exercise up here today. We're going to come down on that mat. I'm going to really flop those abs. I know you love it. Last little bit of cardio. Keeping that heart rate up. Getting that blood rushing around the body. Carrying all that lovely oxygen. That's what we need. Keep ourselves healthy. And COVID free. Hopefully, fingers crossed. Last eight. Four to go. Three. Two. Last one. Just finish off. Warm down those legs. Don't just stop it. Heart rate comes down. Regulate the breathing. Good. Four. Shallow. Three. Two. One. Now just walk it out. Walk it round. Walk around the living room. There you go, come back. Oh, there you are. Give me some waves. Give me a thumbs up if everybody's okay. Everyone all right? You're all good. Boundary. Thank you. I think that was Hazel.
Okay. But, hey,
we're going to work on those abs.
Oh, thank you.
Let's grab a mat. I can hear you giggling, that's all. But never mind. We are going to work
on those abdominals.
Alrighty. Are we ready? Just keep yourself some little weights to hand, because some of these exercises, if you feel that it's a little bit easy, or maybe you want to challenge yourself a little bit more, just grab some pound weights and add them to the exercise. I'm just going to turn these down because I feel that I'm really shouting. Not at you, mind you, just so I can be heard. So, down we go, guys. Nice and easy to begin with. You know the drill, we're going to fire up. Now, can you all see me lying on the floor? Who can I see? Thumbs up. Claire, can you see me on the floor? Good. Yep. Perfect. Good. So, lying down, hands on thighs. Nice and comfy. Squeeze those abs. All right, let's do a little exercise. Lie down, everybody. Now, I want you to squeeze those tummy muscles in with all your might and hold for three. One, two, three, and relax. So, breath in. Squeeze it tight, tighter. One, two, three, exhale. That is your movement when we're doing abdominals. You breathe out on the exertion. So when you're down here, squeezing the tummy in, when you come up, you breathe it out. So join me when you're ready. In, out, in, out. I want you to keep that pace. I don't want you to go any further. Breathe in. As you come up, breathe out. In and out. Good. In on the floor, out as you come up here. In and out. In. If you feel that you can add a little bit of resistance, just grab some weights. Come in and breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Good. We've got eight more here. Just to get a bit of warmth into those abs, just firing them up. Good. We've got four more to go. In, out, in, squeeze. Two more. Last one. Good job, hug those knees in. And just rock from side to side if that's right for you. Alrighty. Nice work. So, at any time throughout any of these next exercises, if you feel it's too much, it's pulling on your back in a bad way, because that's what we don't want. If it's pulling on your back, your form is not quite right. So I will need you to stay after. When we have a little chat, and I'll just maybe give you some tips on that. The important thing is, you pull the tummy in and you push the back into the floor. That way, you're going to protect that back. And always make sure your pelvis is slightly lifted. Remember those pelvic floor muscles we all did? Yeah, they're really important. You need to keep that going. So, anytime you find these next exercises too much, go back to what we were just doing there. So, we're going to row our boat now. So, you need to make sure that you're in a nice, comfortable position. If you can see me, I'm just going to come back a little bit here. Alrighty, so I'm in this tucked position, my feet are off the floor. Okay, so I'm going to start here. I'm then going to row my boat. So I'm going to pull my oars in and push my legs out and forward and back. So join me when you can. Some of you I can see your form, others I can't. So it's really important, this good form. So suck in the tummy, make sure you're sat on your sit bones here, off your sit bones rather. Pull back, don't let those feet down, keep your feet up. Good. This is really going to work on those tummy muscles. It's an excellent exercise. Once your abs are warmed up in the morning, this is a really good one for you to do. How many can you do? Maybe you can do six on the first day, six on the second day. Maybe you can do eight on the third day. It's up to you. You might do 100, I don't know. It's your exercise. I want you to enjoy it, work through it, and keep those abs squeezed. We've got eight to go. number five. Can you feel those quads working now? Should be able to.
Oh, yeah.
We've just done a lot of squats. Last two. Make them your best ones. There's a lot of rowing going on out there. Alrighty. Now, just stay here, squeeze it, or lie on your back. Squat from side to side. Nice and easy. Alrighty, so while those abs are still fired up, we need to move into the next section. So remember, at any time you feel you just can't possibly go on, we need to go back to those original ones that we're doing, with or without the weights, just go up and down. Alrighty, so now we're going to start working on those obliques. So, fingertips by temples. Feet in, legs in tabletop position. I'm going to cross my right arm to my right left leg, and then my right leg goes out straight. So this is the position you end up in. Come back and cross it over the other way. Now, I want you to do it slowly. I don't want it fast. If you struggle, keep going, ladies and gentlemen. If you struggle with this here, keep the leg bent. But if you can, I want you to straighten this bottom leg down and just about an inch off the floor, because that's really going to work those abdominals really hard. So again, you need to do it at the level that you're comfortable at, but I want you to challenge yourself. I can't challenge you, I'm not in your room. So it's down to you to challenge yourself. So, try to keep the feet off the floor. Make it smooth, not juddery. Feel those obliques really working hard now. Good. Oh, excellent work. Squeeze that tummy. Squeeze it into the floor. There should be no pulling in your back whatsoever. Squeeze the hip. Good. Are you ready to start our final eight? I think that was a yes. Here we go. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Straight into toe touches. Come on, join me. This is where your challenge comes in. Push. Squeeze and push. Come on. You can do it.
Oh, I can't.
Yes, you can. I can hear you. Push. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four.
Four.
Three.
Three.
Two. One.
Oh.
And hugging those knees. Excellent work. Really well done. Everyone okay? Give me a thumbs up.
Yeah.
Well done. All right, grab a quick drink if you need it.
I feel thinner already, Jen.
Oh, I'm so pleased to hear that. That's what we need. Okay, next set of exercises.
Is there more?
Oh, there's more. There's always more. Always more.
Yeah.
So, do 100. So, I'm just going to fold my mat over. I've got a bit of a tailbone issue. So, you want to be sat on your sit bones in a V position. Now, my feet are off the floor. I don't know if you can actually see my feet. I might, if I turn you around, you might get a better view of me. I don't know. Is that any better?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. Oh, good. Right. I've got to watch I don't fall down because there's a unit behind me. So, feet off. I'm balanced on my bottom. I've got a bit of a C going on here, not a V. I'm not in this position. I'm in a C. So I'm protecting my back. I've got to tuck the pelvis under, yeah? So tuck it under, and then my position is in a C. But from here, we're going to push down with strong arms. Are you ready for 100? Twenty. Forty. Squeeze it. Oh, Claire, I like it. Yeah. Oh, yes. I like it. I've lost count now, Claire. I think that's 60. 40 more to go. We can do a little bit of... Yeah, who's with me? Getting into those obliques. I think that's about 80. Last 20. Come on. Squeeze it. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16. You're going to take off in a minute, Claire. 14, 13, 12, 10, no, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, 7. The record stopped. 4, 3, 2, 1. And hugging those knees. Oh. Well, let's have a little rock from side to side. Fantastic work. We have got one more exercise left. Free Christmas cracker to those that know what the last ab exercise is going to be.
Claire.
I hear you say. Christmas cracker to you. All righty. Are we ready? Yes, planks, ladies. Can't finish off an ab exercise without a lovely plank. So, we are going to be doing a full plank, thus... Nice and straight and strong. However, if you want to come down on your knees, you do. I'll do that very well on my knees here. So, full plank. And then if you're doing a half plank, you literally just rest the knees down. I don't want to see any bottoms coming up. I don't want to see any beautiful arches in the back. It is completely straight from the tip of your head to the tip of your bottom. That is a completely straight line. Let me look.
Sorry, Claire, I know you weren't ready then. All right, are we ready?
Plank positions.
I've done that.
Well done. Paper's done extra. Keep going. Hold the switch. Yeah. Now, let's think about our posture. Our head is nice and aligned with our back. It's not down, it's not up. Think about your shoulders. Your shoulder blades should be directly above your elbow. So your arms are stacked. That's going to protect your rotator cuff. Your tummy is squeezed in. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Your glutes are squeezed. The thighs are squeezed. And you're pushing away with your heels now. Rock forward, push away. Rock forward, push away. If you're on your knees, rock forward slightly, but don't drop the bottom down. Rock forward slightly, push back. Small movement. It's just going to emphasize the movement a bit more. Push it back. Push. Good. Hold it there. Hold and squeeze. Left leg out, left leg in. Right leg out, right leg in. Left leg out, and back, and out, and back. Left leg up, and down. Right leg up, and down. Left leg up, and down. Right leg up and down. Hold and squeeze. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and baby pose. Ooh. Fabulous work, everybody. Well done. We're now going to just cool down, do some stretches, and then I'll see who's is joining me for the 10:15 class. Is anybody here doing the 10:15 class, by the way? Claire is, right, perfect. So this is gonna be a 5-minute stretch. And then if you want a more in-depth stretch, please stay on and join me. It's only a little half hour class, but I think you'll find it very enjoyable. Okay, so let's sit up nice and tall, soles of our feet together. And just enjoy some nice deep breaths. In through the nose and out through the mouth. You can do out through the mouth in your own living room. I'm in the studio, we have to breathe in through the nose and out through the nose because we don't want to spread our germs. But in your own space, in through the nose, out through the mouth. Just going to turn to face you. Keep that nice bit of ease of breathing going. Oh. My floor is so sweaty and my mat's stuck to it now. It's lovely. I have to have a little bit of a mop later. Alrighty, so sit up nice and tall. Deep breath in. Lift that chin. Now I want you to fold from the hip forward. Good. Just feel that lovely stretch. Now you're going to feel the stretch in the outer part of your thigh into the glute area. Cross the top of the shoulders because you're pulling down here. And then into that adductor area, into that groin. Good. Now sit up nice and tall. Take both arms up and stretch up to the ceiling. And just slightly dip down to one side, very gently. Good, and back up to center. And very gently to one side, good. Back to center. Now drop the left hand down. This time as you lean over, you're gonna get a little bit further because you've got a bit of support. So you feel a really nice stretch right the way up the side. Good, and swap over. Right hand down, left hand up. Now push up towards the ceiling and then push away and tilt over. Good. And come back. Now one hand over the other, drop the chin to the chest. Now push. Now I want you to think about your shoulder blades. As you push away, protract those shoulder blades and push them away round the back. Push. Good. Bring the hands back in. Come back up. Lift that chest. Breath in. Take the hands behind. Pop them in the small of your back. And squeeze the elbows together. Really open up this chest area. Good job. We're going to go back into our all four position. So tabletop position for me. Hopefully you can see me. Yes, you can. Good. So from here, we're going to do some cat and cow stretches. So again, make sure our weight is stacked. Shoulder directly over wrist and hips directly over knees. Tabletop position. Head is in neutral position. And then we drop it slightly to the chest. We arch the back. We suck in the tummy and we protract those shoulders. Then we reverse that. We lift the chin, we stick out the bottom, we let the back arch very slightly, and we retract the shoulders. We pull the shoulder blades down the back. Good. Got one more each of those. Round it up. And back down. Good. From here, we're going to go into a down dog position. So tuck your toes under. Pop your hands away, maybe. Push the hips up and out and come back through so that your head is in line with your hands. My hands are slipping already. There we go. There we are. So heels off the floor in a nice, comfortable down dog position. Now from here, we're going to push one heel down and soften the other knee. So we're working the back of the calf muscles in the back. Now don't forget about those tummy muscles all the time. I want them squeezed in. Squeeze it. Push the heel down into the floor and soften the other knee. Four, three, two, one. Good job. So from your down dog position, I want you to just drop the knees down very gently. Lovely. So you're back into that tabletop position. Now just come up, put the left leg in front. So my right knee is on the floor and I've chopped my head off, but never mind. Just lean forward into that hip flexor, into this groin area. Good. Both hands in, down into the inside of the trainer. Now you can stay here with that stretch, that's fine. If you want a bit more, tap the toe under and bring the right leg up, right knee off the floor. Good. Again, you can stay here. If you want a bit more, you push yourself up, raise the hands, drop the hip down. Slight arch in the spine area. Good, so we've got a lovely little bit of stretch going in on that lumbar part of our spine. Good, come back down gently. Drop the knee, raise the knee. Pop the toes back down on the floor. And then left hand goes back into that inner thigh, into inner shoe. And then the right hand comes up
And you're really going to open up this chest area. So left hand down, right hand up. Squeeze it out. Good. Now we're going to just change and do that all on the other leg. So start off with this hip flexor stretch. Get both hands down to the inside of the trainer. You can stay here if you want to. If you want to take it up a bit, come up onto the toe, push the knee off the floor. Push the back heel away. You can stay here. If you want a bit more, you're going to push up into that beautiful position, slight arch in the spine, and down.
Sorry, I fell over.
Drop the knee down, take the other knee behind, and sit back into that baby pose. Here, we're just going to finish off stretching out those quad muscles. So rest your forearm on one arm, take the other hand behind and squeeze that ankle into your bottom. And you're stretching out the quads. And change. And relax, good job. Then come back in. One more time, back into that baby pose. Now this time, really walk the fingers away and push the elbows and the forearms into the floor. You feel a really nice stretch in those biceps. Good, and up you come. And give yourself a big round of applause. Right on. Fabulous work, everybody. So thanks, Jan, for joining me. Kat has a class tomorrow at, I think it's 6:15, cool. Stretch and Tone. So join her if you can. And then MJ has a Wednesday morning Stretch and Flex class. So again, join her if you can. There are plenty of these videos on YouTube. There's plenty of these videos on our website. So feel free, over this period, just to, you know, grab yourself a mat and go through. I was actually watching something on TV this morning. Don't ask me what side it was. Quite interesting. There's one for little kiddies, which is a lot of fun. There was a yoga-y thing on, and then there was a cardio, like a little HIIT section. So, you know, there's plenty on the telly, so don't let yourself feel that you can't do any exercise, because you can. It's just having the motivation to do it, and that's what I'm here for, but I'm not going to be with you on Christmas Day. But I will be working out. So, if you want to join me, do it in your own living room, because you can't come around the house. So have a lovely rest of the day.
Thanks, Jan.
Hi, Sarah. Hi, Louise. How are you?
All right, darling.
There may be some classes in between Christmas and New Year. Dean will let us know. He'll put them on the website.
So, thanks, Jan.
Thank you very much.
Bye. Happy Christmas, darling.
If you're staying for the stretch class, it will start in about 30 seconds. I'm just going to move my weights out the way. And we will start a lovely, gentle stretch. Just you and me, Claire?
Oh, do I need to, because it's got a different meeting number, do I need to go away and come back again?
Do you know what? I don't know the answer to that. No, I don't think so, because we've done it before, we've just carried on.
No.
I think maybe it was for people that just wanted to do the stretch class.
Oh, right, okay.
No one else has joined us, so no, I'd stay where you are, Claire.
Okay, I'll go and mute. Shall I mute myself again?
Yes, just mute yourself, that's it. Okay. I'm just going to grab a quick drink. Right, so we want some nice stretchy music. Thank you.
Right, okay. So, we're going to start off, I think, lying down. Come on, Max. In a full body stretch. I'm going to take my trainers off, I think. I really enjoy this nice stretch. I haven't had a proper stretch since I did yoga on Friday, so. I did a big walk. I did a big walk Friday afternoon. And then I'm going to do another big walk today. So I need to do lots of stretching. So full body stretch. Lovely, Claire. Well done. Whew. There we go. And just nice, easy, gentle breathing. Just going to shut that door so I'm a bit cold. Ooh. There we are. Nice and stretched. Okay, now I want you to bring both knees up and just hug them in to the chest. And just slightly rock very gently from side to side. Nice and easy. And I want you to put the left foot down flat on the floor. And I want you to hug the right thigh into the chest. And then I want you to reach, stretch those toes of the right foot up towards the ceiling. But I want you to keep this knee nice and soft. And then hold just behind the thigh. And just feel a lovely little stretch. You can close your eyes while you're doing this if you want to. Just keep that breathing nice and gentle, nice and easy. Good. Now I want you to just rotate the ankle one way, gently does it. Really feeling each of those rotations, so don't rush it. Good. Two, one. And now I want you to rotate the ankle back the other way. Really think about that ankle. Giving it a big, nice, wide sweep. Three, two, one. Jolly good. And now I want you to take a breath in. And as you exhale, I want you to bring that leg, that thigh towards your chest a little bit more, but I want you to keep your back, low back on the floor. And then you might want to hold a bit higher up, but I want you to keep the knee soft. I don't want it locking out. I want the knee soft and really just pull it nice and gently towards you. And then I want you to push the heel away now. So the toe comes towards you and the heel is being pushed up towards the ceiling. And again, if you don't want to hold the back of the leg, if that stretch is enough for you, that's fine. But if you want a little bit more stretch and you just want to pull that leg towards you a little bit more gently, but push the heel away. Lovely. That's a great stretch. Now the left leg, which is the foot is still on the floor, I want you to push that left leg so that it is now lying straight on the floor. Good. So the right leg is up. In the air, heel is being pushed away, but the left leg is straight flat on the floor. Now I want you to pull the right thigh back down towards you, allow the knee to bend. Left hand goes to the outside of the right knee, right hand comes out onto the floor, palm down. Now I want you to look at the right hand, keep the right shoulder on the floor, and I want you to just gently ease the right knee away from you. Just apply a slight little bit of pressure. And then take it as far as it's comfortable for you to go in that stretch for now. This is the first little gentle stretch we're doing, so you might not push it all the way. Take it nice and easy. Keep this right shoulder on the floor. And then if you want to, you can just rest the right foot on the left knee. So it just takes that pressure out of the leg, but you've still got this beautiful stretch in this hip area, right into that right glute.
Good. Now I want the left hand to also go out, palm down. So both hands are out, both palms are down. You're still looking at the right hand. My right foot is still resting on my left knee, but now I want to stretch that right leg out as far as it is comfortable to go. Again, it might be up in the air. Keep that right shoulder down. And then I just want you to pull, to push the toe up towards the left hand. Good. Just watch this hip area here. Just think about it. How does it feel? Push that up, that toe up towards the left hand a little bit more. Your foot is possibly off the floor. If you're very flexible, it might be on the floor. And just breathe through. Now I want you to bend that right leg. Good. And I want you to turn back onto your back. Rest the right foot down. Bring the other leg up to meet it. So now both feet are flat on the floor. And then bring the knees into the chest and just hug in those knees. Allow the knee, the nose to try and touch the knees. Make yourself into a little ball. And stretch that out again. Good. Now we're gonna repeat all of that on the left side. So, start off with both feet on the floor. So this time my right foot stays on the floor, but my left leg comes up. Again, nice soft knee. Hold behind the thigh if that's right for you. Sucking in the tummy, pushing it back into the floor. These are all gentle stretching movements. There should be no straining, no pain. Now we're going to start by rotating the ankle of the left leg. So the left ankle, basically. Big rotational movements. Really feel those. Enjoy that lovely stretching of the ankle. And again, listen to the body. If you've got some little creaks and groans and funny noises coming from the joints, as long as it's not painful, you know your own body. It could be a natural occurrence when you do that. I know mine do often click. Rotate back the other way. We've got quite clicky ankles. Good. 3, 2, 1. And relax. Good. Now, you're just going to pull that leg in towards you a little bit more. Now, maybe your grip will go up a little bit higher, maybe around to the calf. It's entirely up to you. Keep the knee soft. Back is supported on the floor. You don't raise anything, you don't raise the bottom. So keep that leg there. Now I want you to think about that ankle again, and I want you to push the heel away from you. So this stretch now goes a little bit deeper into the calf muscle as well. Good. Just breathe through, just enjoy that lovely stretch. Now this is where we slide the right foot down and away. Slide it down. Good. Now push the heel away of the right foot. Push the heel away of the left foot. So the right leg is down, pushing the heel away. The left leg is up, pushing the heel away. And just hold where it's comfortable. Good. Now we're going to bring the right leg back into towards the chest area. The left hand is going to go away in line with our head, palm down. Right hand is going to go towards the outer side of the left knee. And this is where we just start pushing that left knee away. We're looking towards our left hand. We're pushing the left knee across to the right. And we're starting to let the spine just very, very gently just move over across the body. Very importantly, I want you to keep that left shoulder on the floor. So if you start coming over too far and your left shoulder raises, you need to come back. Just apply a little bit of pressure on the outside of the left knee. Good. And then when it's as far as you think it's going to go, just allow the foot to rest on the top of the right knee. So there's no, you're not holding it up, it's not shaking, but you've got a beautiful stretch in that spine, thoracic and lower spine. Just feel that stretch, just breathe through the stretch, listening to your body, what's it doing, how's it feeling? And now we're just going to stretch out that left leg. So very gently let it stretch out. Might not want to come far. Your right hand will need to come out to support you. So now your right hand and your left hand are level with your shoulders, palms down. And my right, left leg is on top of my right leg. And I'm just feeling that lovely stretch. When I'm as far as I want to go, I just allow the toe to drop down onto the floor. So that hip now is really in full stretch. And breathe. And then we're going to think about folding that leg back in, nice and gently, nice and slowly. Just fold the knee in, rotate the body so it comes back in a lying position. Place the left foot back down on the floor. Bring the right foot back up to join it. Knees are pointing towards the ceiling, both feet are flat on the floor. Bolt the knees and the ankles together. Bring both the thighs in to meet the chest. Wrap yourself around with the hands and then try and get your knee as close to your nose, as close to your knees, into a nice small ball. Just rock gently from side to side. Then allow the head to go back down onto the floor. We're going to go back into that full body stretch. Nice and gently, nice and easy. Push the fingers away, push the heels away, push the legs into the floor. And breathe. Lovely work, good. Just roll over onto one side, doesn't matter which side, possibly facing me might be easier. And just rest your head in the crook of your arm and allow, if you're on a mat, allow yourself to be in line with the mat. So the back, my bottom and my feet all in a line here. I'm just going to rest my head gently in the crook of this arm, adjust myself so I'm on my hip. Nice and comfy. This hand here is just going to rest out in front of me. Now I'm just going to lift the top knee, keeping the soles of my feet together, just allowing and feeling that lovely pressure in that glute muscle. Good. And then just drop it back down again. I'm trying to keep my body nice and still. So the only bit that's working is this outer hip area. So this is why this hand here is supporting me. My head stays looking ahead. And then I'm just gonna keep my feet as if they're tied together and raise that knee, taking it out as wide as possible without rocking back. If I rock back, I can go as wide as I want to, but I don't want that. I wanna keep this part of my body still. Just take that back there. Now, some people are gonna be more flexible than me. That's not very wide there, but I can really feel it in this glute area here. Good, bring it back down. We're going to do that four more times. Do it in your own time, gently. Keep yourself supported. Raise it. Your feet are tied together, they can't move. You stay on the opposite hip. Good. Got one more to go. Each time you maybe push out an extra little half an inch and release it. Good. Excellent work. Now I'm going to stretch out the bottom leg so that that bottom leg is now straight, and then this leg, the knee just comes up and raises on the top. If you can see that. Yes, you can, Claire. Good. So stay with my head on the crook of my arm. This time I'm going to push this toe away. So I'm going to stretch it out here. So my left leg is on the floor. My right leg is also on the floor, but it's out in front of me. So this is an L shape here. Just rest wherever it is comfortable on there. Good. Now I want you to bring this knee up to your nose, or as far as it's going to go. Good. So what's happened here, you should have shifted your hip forward, but my leg is still on the floor. This, my other hip, I'm lying on this still, I haven't moved that. All I've done is brought this knee up towards me a bit further. Now I'm going to push the toe out. So now, instead of that being in a 90 degree angle, it's almost in a 45 degree angle. So it's pushing away further up. So it's almost in line with my head, that foot. But this hip hasn't moved, I'm lying on. Good. Again, bring this knee in and then pushing yourself down gently, roll back onto your back. And then we're going to do it on the other side. I just need to turn around so I'm still facing you. That's it. So we're going to do exactly the same on this side, Claire. So get nice and comfy. We start off with our clam. So just going to lean into the crook of the hand, crook of the arm. Good. Now really bolt those feet together. Ankles are tied. Good. And then we're going to start raising that bottom, that top knee. Good. Lovely. So this here, if you put your hand on this hip, it doesn't move at all. The only thing that's moving is this top leg. You can feel that lovely squeeze in that glute. Good. Push it away and squeeze and squeeze and squeeze. Lovely. Good. This is a really nice pace to do it as well, because we're feeling the squeeze. You'll also feel a nice, you have to squeeze the core to be able to raise that leg, because the rest of your body is staying still. You might find also that your pelvic floor, you should get a squeeze in the pelvis. Lovely. I'm going to do four more. Two to go. Last one. Good. Now you're going to stretch out the bottom foot and just allow that top knee just to come forward for a moment. Good. And just feel that lovely stretch here again. Now we're going to push the toes away. So we now got this 45, this 90 degree angle here. Nice and gentle. You're going to pull that knee towards you one more time. And then because the knee's now higher up, as you push that, this foot away. This foot is now, as you push it away, it's now higher up here. So as high as you want it to go, as high as it's comfortable for you. Still relaxing the upper part of your body. Good. And then bring that knee back in and then just roll back over, back onto your back. And we're going to hug those knees in again. Make yourself into that little ball. Good. And push both of the knees away, feet down flat on the floor. And I'm just going to bring one knee in, push it away. Other knee in, push it away. And away. Good. Now this time when we push in, we're just going to reach that foot up towards the ceiling and then allow it to drop down nice and gently. And bring it back in, back to the floor. So again, other knee, pull that knee in, push the heel away. Now allow it to, but just let it go down nice and gently, keep it under tension, and then bring the foot back up on the floor. So knee in, push the heel away. Now slowly let it go down, control it, and then bring the foot back in, place the foot on the floor, and again. Good, got one more on each leg. Pull in, push away with the heel, and lower it down, good. Other leg. Good. Excellent. Now, can we do it with both legs? So, raise the hips, bring the legs in, push both the heels up towards the ceiling. Now, if you've got any back issues at all, soften the knees and drop them down. Good. One more time. Bring both the knees in, push the knees away. If you have a back issue, allow the knees to soften. If not, put the hands down on the floor to support you. Push the knees away, sorry, the heels away, and lower gently. Gently, gently, and pull in. Good. Got one more of those. You choose which one's right for you. Pull in, push away. Good. And lower gently. Lovely. Excellent work, Claire. Good. Lovely, and pull back in. Excellent, good. Feet back flat on the floor. Arms out nice and wide. Palms facing down. Now we're just gonna bolt the knees and the ankles together. And we're just gonna allow them to drop down very gently to one side. And the head is gonna turn in the opposite direction. So we're back to that thoracic, to that lumbar spine. Lovely lumbar spine twist. Good. Back to center. And drop them to the other side. And head turns in the opposite direction. Good. We've got one more of these on each side. And back to center. Jolly good. And then nice and slowly, nice and gently, in your own time, I want you to come up to a seated position.
Okay.
Okay.
Last little bit of stretch for today. Soles of our feet together. Good. And then we're going to have put our hands in prayer position by our heart, center of our body. Good. And breathe easy. And then we're going to push the hands up gently towards the ceiling and allow them to come out nice and wide. Good. When they get to shoulder height, we're just going to tip down to one side. So my left hand is on the floor, and then I'm going to soften that elbow and keep reaching and reaching. And then the elbow goes down and reaching and reaching and squeezing. Now really push away here. Good. And then again, just nice and slowly and gently, just ease yourself back up. Push away with the elbow, forearm. Good. Bring the other hand up to meet it. Good. Bring those hands back down. Push the elbows away. Push away here. Push away. Good. Push away. And back up. Good. Hands out, come nice and wide, level with the shoulders. This time the opposite hand goes down. And then you're going to lean across, lean over, lean over. So this is where you just slightly tilt. You might need to move your hand a little bit, adjust it. Allow the forearm to go down. Allow the elbow to go down. Sort of a bit of a flop there. And then we reach over and we push. And I can't go any further because I've got a unit in the way. Push away. It's a really lovely stretch right down the side and outside of that arm into the elbow. Good. And then push up. Push away with that elbow hand. Good. And come back up. Good. Bring both hands back down.